Hello students, now we will see the second numerical on psychrometry. Moist air at 30 degree centigrade, 1.01325 bar has a relative humidity of 80%. Determine without using the psychrometric chart A. The partial pressure of water vapor and the air, B. Specific humidity, C. Specific volume, and D. Dew point temperature. Now in this numerical, the dry bulb temperature is given, the pressure at total pressure is given, P is given, dBT is given, and the relative humidity phi is given as 80%. We will consider it as 0.8. And what we are supposed to ask, now without using the psychrometric chart means we have to calculate using the formulas. Okay. The other way is you can use the psychrometric chart and find it out directly without any calculation. But here we are supposed to calculate using the formulas. Now partial pressure means PV, water vapor is PV, and air means PA, okay, and specific humidity is omega, specific volume small v, and DPT, dew point temperature. See, earlier we in the earlier problem we have seen that when we the DPT is given, we find out we can the corresponding saturation pressure is PV. So now it is the other way around. If we know the PV, then we can find out the automatically the saturation temperature is known as dew point temperature. Please remember this. Now, data of the moist air dBT is equal to 30 degree centigrade. Atmospheric pressure or total pressure is 1.01325 bar, is equal to 101.325 kilopascal. Relative humidity is 0.8. To find the partial pressure of water vapor, that is PV, and air, that is PA. Okay, relative humidity is equal to PV by PVS. Now, PV is equal to partial pressure of water vapor, and PVS is partial pressure of water vapor when the air is fully saturated. Now, when because the DBT is given as 30 degree centigrade, the corresponding partial pressure, saturation pressure from the steam table, this saturated water, saturated steam table, PVS, whatever P you get pressure, that is PVS here, that is 0.0424 bar, that is 4.24 kilopascal. Okay, so from steam table you will get the PVS because dry bulb temperature is already given. Now substituting the value of phi and PVS, we will calculate the value of PV. 0.8 is equal to PV by 4.2415. So PV is equal to 3.39 kilopascal. Now total pressure is sum of partial pressure of dry air plus sum of partial pressure of moisture. So now PA is equal to P minus PV, that is 101.325 kilopascal minus 3.39 kilopascal. So partial pressure of air is 97.93 kilopascal. Okay. Partial pressure of vapor is, water vapor is 3.39 kilopascal, and partial pressure of air is 97.93 kilopascal PA. Now to find out specific humidity, the standard formula for specific humidity is P omega is equal to 0.622 PV divided by PA. 0.622 into PV is 3.39, and PA we have calculated just now, so we can directly use PA, or we can also use P minus PV also here. So using directly PA here, 0.622 into 3.39 divided by 97.93, that gives 0.0215. So omega is equal to 0.0215 kg of water vapor per kg of dry air. Now to find out the specific volume of dry air, as we know the ideal gas equation we can apply, PV is equal to MRT. Now suppose I am applying for dry air, so PA into VA is equal to MA into RTA. Okay. VA is equal to, rearranging, VA is equal to, I will take the P bottom here, MARTA divided by PA. So M is considering 1 kg of mass here, then the R of air is 0.287 into temperature I will take in absolute units, that is Kelvin. So 30 plus 273 divided by PA is 97.93. So I am getting VA as 0.888 meter cube per kg of dry air. So using the specific ideal gas equation, we can find out the volume of air. Now the last point is to find out the dew point temperature.